Hey, what's up everyone? It's Carlos here. So we're back on Destiny doing the Daily Strike. So the one for today is actually the one that's featured from House of Wolves. So the storyline there was with the House of Fallen Enemies that betrayed the Queen. And it also included Skolas, I think, which was a pretty cool fallen enemy. So back, I think this was around April of May, or I think 2015, when House of Wolves was released. So originally this expansion was supposed to get a raid, but they never got it. It got exchanged to the Prison of Elders, which I think was still pretty fun. And to this day, I still go back and do the old Prison of Elders, you know, 32, 34, and 35. Just sometimes I'll do it maybe once or twice a week with different characters, but at this point, they don't really give you anything you could use unless maybe you're trying to stock up on some old raid gear like from Vault of Glass or from the Dark Below DLC, which is the Crota stuff. So anyways, so recently during the Dawning, they did update some of the older strikes, three of them. One of them was with, I think it was Tanix, yeah. So they made Tanix perfected to fit the storyline of the whole thing in Rise of Iron with the Siva. So I was thinking, well, if they did that with Tanix, then what if they renewed or updated the Prison of Elders to have a higher light level? Now, I know they had Challenge of Elders, which I think is a different thing. However, Prison of Elders had different bosses that were very unique and had some very interesting mechanics. So I was thinking, well, if they brought back Skolas, you know, the Prison of Elders 34 mission, and they remade him with, you know, a higher light level, would they choose to do it either with the Siva version, which I'm guessing they might do, or what about a Taken version? That's another twist on things they could do. Now, I don't mind them bringing back some older stuff and increasing the light level. I mean, there's been a lot of talks on the Bungie.net forums where people want to see the Vault of Glass and the Dark Below raids come back with higher light level because they miss the old raids. Now, I for one, I've done the older raids every now and then, sometimes once or twice a week, just to kind of play them for fun. At this point, I mean, it's really old gear and they don't really give anything you could use unless you want to take the old materials and convert them into motes of light or into glimmer, whatever you want. But at this point in Destiny, the older raids are pretty much just obsolete. Now, if you're a collector, you can go back and get the older gear, but at this point, I don't really want to go back and do them every single week over and over because there's really no point. Now, especially if I'm farming like, say, Glimmer or, Motes of Light, then I can find another way to basically farm that kind of stuff. But in terms of getting the materials and exchange them into Motes of Light or into Glimmer, I think that's a very slow progress. So, I think it's a cool thing there, bring back some older stuff and renewing the light level, you know, make them better. But once again, we also have the King's Fall raid, which is still back from 2015 and then ended up in 2016 of September. And the light level there is still pretty much at 335. However, that gear there and all the weapons, like the armor and stuff and the relics and the ghosts, all that stuff can still be infused. So that's a pretty good thing there. However, I run most of my gear on my Warlock with the King's Fall raid gear because I really like the look of it, and also on my Titan. But on my Hunter, I'm running the newer stuff or some separate types of cloaks. So I look back at this stuff and I'm like thinking, well, during House of Wolves, I really liked the gear in the Prison of Elders, and I liked the whole thing with Prison of Elders. And there's a bunch of activities out in Destiny that are still really outdated, and yes, some fans want to see them come back, but at the same time, would it be worth it? Because I did mention this before, and it's like saying, well, when Rise of Iron came out, if you got that DLC, then you had the ability to go up to 400 light pretty easily. However, if you didn't buy it, then you're kind of stuck at a lower light level. So it's like, if they update the old Prison of Elders activities, you know, like 32, 34, and 35, and make them say maybe 40, 41, and 42, then that would mean that someone who plays on the old House of Wolves DLC and does not purchase Rise of Iron, then they would have the ability to reach a higher light level without getting the new DLC. So, on a standpoint of business and, of course, money-wise for Bungie, that wouldn't really make sense. But they did bring back some strikes, like the Nexus and also Tanix and also Omnigul. And they increased the light level. So it's like, well, we can bring back these older strikes because it doesn't make much of a big difference in terms of light level. So, with that being said, it's like they're willing to renew some older strikes, which won't really have a big impact on their sales for Rise of Iron. But if they bring back old activities like, Vault of Glass, The Dark Below, or House of Wolves, that would mean people could reach a high light level, like say up to 400, getting those rewards. Of course, if they had rewards up to that light level, then they can get to a very high light level getting those rewards without having to buy Rise of Iron, which kind of, interferes with, their sales. So it's like, is it worth updating the older activities to a higher light level? Now, what if they did it to where they said, well, if we update the older activities to a higher light level and their rewards can go up to 400, then they'll probably put a restriction on saying if you want to play the older activities like Vault of Glass, Dark Below, and also the Prison of Elders with the new light level, you would need to buy the new Rise of Iron expansion. So that would really put a stranglehold on some new people getting into Destiny. Now, let's say you were playing Destiny for a very long time and you just never bought Rise of Iron, and then now you're thinking, well, let's say maybe in a few months they say, we're going to update the older activities, but if you want to replay them at a high light level, you're kind of blocked. You can't go into them because you never bought Rise of Iron. So there's a couple of different choices they can make concerning the older raids, and at the same time, it would have an impact on their sales with Rise of Iron because that expansion is what allows you to get up to 400 lights. So, yeah. So, in a way, it would get in some kind of, I guess, turbulence affecting the sales of Rise of Iron if they updated the older activities with rewards up to 400 light. Now, say you never bought Rise of Iron, but you did buy, say, the House of Wolves and Dark Below, then you'd be able to reach 400 light doing the older activities without having to buy Rise of Iron, and that wouldn't really make enough sense because out of everyone else who purchased Rise of Iron, we can reach the high light level, and just doesn't seem fair for someone who never bought it to reach the highest light level. So I think that's the main reason they're not updating the older raids right away. Now, I did make a video about this a long time ago, and I mentioned the same thing. If they do make a choice to bring back the older activities, like Vault of Glass, Dark Below, Prison of Elders, then if they increase the light level, then it might take a very long time. But if they do it sometime in 2017, it would not surprise me if they put a cap or some kind of restriction on the older activities. So there's a bunch of problems there, but I would like to see Skolas come back. I want to do Prison of Elders 32, 34, and 35 again because they're really fun to do. So, what about you guys? Let me know your thoughts down below in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.